Very good morning to all the students of 9C as well as 9D. Diksha, then you have to check your beta network or you can rejoin if problem is coming, because all the students are saying my voice is audible to them and board is visible to them clearly. So kindly check network on your part or your camera. Okay, most of the students I have already asked them. So let's continue, beta. We are about to finish this chapter. Value points of my childhood. This is extract from autobiography of Wings of Fire. Okay. Clear? Kalam's science teacher, Mr. Iyer, invited him for a meal. We have read so far that incident when a new teacher mistreated them and asked Kalam to sit at the back desk. And both of them, they informed their parents, and finally, teacher was taught a lesson by the head priest of the Rameshwaram temple. We have read so far. We have seen a video also yesterday. So now we'll be reading further. Kalam's science teacher, Mr. Iyer, invited him for a meal. So his science teacher was very genuine man, very honest personality. He believed in creating harmony. He wanted to stop creating differences on the grounds of religion. So he was very nice man. He knew that Abdul Kalam is very talented boy who has interest in science and maths. So Kalam's science teacher, Mr. Iyer, invited him for a meal at his own home. What happened next? Teacher's wife was very conservative. Some people are not alike, obviously. Husband was very good, but wife was very conservative. The person with very, you can say, small viewpoint. Conservative viewpoint. She believed in creating differences on the basis of religion. So what happened next? Next time she treated Kalam nicely without any discrimination. So what happened, that I'll be telling you in the story. I won't disclose everything here in the value points. Some students are still joining. So teacher's wife mistreated. She was very conservative. But next time when even Kalam was hesitating in joining his teacher again, but teacher said, you have to come to my house if you want to, make people change. Clear? Then you have to visit my house. And next time, wife was very nice. She herself was treating nicely. She was, feeding Kalam on her own, and that change just came because her husband was good enough to teach her a lesson in equality. So then Kalam, further than after this incident, beta, of inviting on meal and all, then we have next event. Then Kalam decided to go to Ramanathpura to study further. So he wanted to fly in the sky. Fly in the sky here means he wanted to spread his wings. He knew that if he'll be staying at the same place, he won't be able to have multiple opportunities. So what he did, he asked his father's permission that if you allow me, only then I would be going to this place for my higher studies. So his father believed in giving freedom to children. As you can see, last point is his father believed in giving freedom to his children. Fine. And he believed that though biologically he was the father, but he believed that every individual person has different set of viewpoint. We should accept it gracefully. Okay. So that was the lesson taught by his father. So his father believed in individuality of a person. Clear? So this is what we are going to read today. Let's not waste time. I would be sharing the screen with you all. Yes. So here you can see now science teacher and Abdul Kalam is sitting with his Brahmin friend happily after that incident. On the whole, the small society of Rameshwaram was very rigid in terms of the segregation of different social groups. That beta, we have already read. Fine, that people were good enough in that is. Sorry. Fine. And they were not believing in segregation of society on the basis of caste and religion. So he did his best to break social barriers so that people from varying backgrounds could mingle easily. He used to spend hours with me and would say, Kalam, I want you to develop so that you are on par with the highly educated people of the big cities. So his teacher, you know, teachers have that, you can say, observation power. Even they know that which student stands where. So science teacher could see that this boy is very hardworking. He has passion for sciences. That's why, you know, he became aeronautical, you can say, scientist later on, APJ Abdul Kalam. And see, his teacher's observation was correct, that he was very intelligent boy. So he says, I want you to become very successful later on. So one day he invited the teacher, the science teacher. So he invited APJ Abdul Kalam at his home. And his wife, I already told you, she was very conservative. She was horrified at the idea of a Muslim boy being invited to dine in her ritually pure kitchen. And, you know, people those days used to sit, wash their hands, and they would have meal by sitting on the floor only. And after having meal, they would clean the place. They would keep their utensils. And these days, what kids are doing, they're just, wherever they're sitting, they're keeping the utensils there. They're asking their mothers to pick up the utensils. That is very bad. Those days, it was a practice that everybody will do the cleaning himself or herself only. So, Shiv Subramania Iyer is his full name, was not perturbed. He was not disturbed. Perturbed means he was not at all affected. Nor did he get angry with his wife. When he saw that my wife was doing discrimination on the basis of religion, that this Muslim boy has come to our house and they are from this Brahmin family. But he did not say anything to his wife. Rather, he quietly sat with APJ Abdul Kalam. He started feeding him with his own hands. His wife was watching everything behind the kitchen door. So I wondered whether she had observed any difference in the way I ate rice. So now, see, this is the mindset of APJ at very young age. He's thinking, is there any difference that how a Muslim eats rice or how a Brahmin eats rice? Is there any difference that how a Muslim drinks water and how a Brahmin drinks water? Is there any difference that how I clean the floor, how my teacher cleaned the floor? Fine. So this is the thing. There is no difference. We all are alike. We all are same. But the difference is in the minds of the people only. Clear? When I was leaving his house, Shiv Subramania Iyer invited me to join him for dinner again the next weekend. Observing my hesitation, he told me not to get upset, saying, see, underline this, Mita. Once you decide to change the system, such problems have to be confronted. Fine? We should not hesitate when people are doing discrimination. We have to face it. We have to confront it too. We need to change the people's mindset by confronting it. Okay? So when I visited his house the next week, Shiv Subramania Iyer's wife took me inside her kitchen. Still some students are coming, see, after 15 minutes of this lecture program. Very bad it is. When I visited his house the next week, Shiv Subramania Iyer's wife took me inside her kitchen and served me food with her own hands. So maybe in that meeting, after seeing that there is no difference how that young boy was eating and how my husband treated, maybe that was the time when a change came in Mr. Iyer's wife. So next time she fed that boy, APJ Abdul Kalam, with her own hands. So 10th paragraph I'm going to read. Then the Second World War was over and India's freedom was prominent. Fine. Indians will build their own India, declared Gandhiji. The whole country was filled with an unprecedented optimism. I asked my father for permission to leave Rameshwaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramanathpuram. So now World War II was over. That was the time when India was going to get independent. India was going to be independent India. Now people can go wherever they wanted to go. That was the new beginning only. So at this time, he asked his father's permission that I want to pursue higher studies in Ramanathpuram while leaving Rameshwaram. He was living in Mosque Street in Rameshwaram. Remember, that is a question also. So he sought his permission. Father gave his consent. Last paragraph. He told me as if thinking aloud, Abul, I know you have to go away to grow. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest? So this is the beautiful example. He's actually quoting Kahlil Gibran, another famous writer, philosopher, thinker. So his father started giving quotation of this man, Kahlil Gibran. He says, I know you have to go away to grow. If you want to grow, you have to take different experiences. You have to go further. You have to fly in the sky. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest? So if you want to achieve, you have to leave your nest. He quoted Kahlil Gibran to my hesitant mother. Hesitant mother means mother, you know, was not at all ready maybe. Mother was hesitant. So mother was saying that if my son goes all alone, what will happen to him? You know, mothers are always caring, but your children are not your children. His father gave the explanation that they are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. See, beautiful line. Means you are the biological parents to them, but you cannot, you know, suppose if a person wanted to be a singer or dancer or actor or a teacher, but he could not become because of the circumstances, does it mean that he will force his children to become so? Aisa nahi hona chahiye. If a parent could not become an engineer, he cannot force his own son to be an engineer. Maybe his son does not have interest or capability of becoming an engineer. So it is the choice of children only. Whatever they want to become, whatever career they want to pursue, fine. Though our parents have given birth to us, they have raised us, given values to us. But it doesn't mean that, you know, we are not free to choose our profession. So with parents' permission, okay? So this varies from family to family, what sort of circumstances they are having, okay? So they come through you, but not from you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. Fine. Sometimes parents believe in something else. You believe in something else. Everybody is in individuality is there. You know, individual thoughts are there. For they have their own thoughts. We should not, you know, force someone to think in that particular direction. We can preach values in them, but let them be free to have their own thoughts. So this is it. Now we will be, let me, before sharing, discussing the question answers, be showing you a small video so that you can remember this incident. Wait. So, beta, I'm going to share this incident of science teacher Mr. Ayer. Fine, how he would teach happily, honestly, in a very, you can say, diligent manner to his students, and he was a very loving teacher, and he had special love for APJ Abdul Kalam, and how he invited him to home. That incident I'm going to share with you all.
She was a woman, though he was also very professional. He encouraged us to be together with his contemporaries and social status. So when we end with the school, I was motivated. And one such person was one of them. I was so happy. I was afraid of.
So this is the way I was discussing, a very simple way of having meal, sitting on the floor. In earthen pot, they would drink water on leaves. Fine. They would have their meals, and after eating, they would clean the place. And how one Brahmin teacher with Muslim teacher, Muslim students sitting together. Fine. So APJ Abdul Kalam was, you know, used to solve his, used to ask many questions to the teacher, and then he found that this boy is very intelligent, keeps on solving his doubts and always ready to learn. So that's why teacher called him at home so that he can help him in studies also. So this is the way, this is what the teacher taught. He gave a lesson that he decided to change the system. Such problems have to be faced. You have to face the situation rather than you just run or you become an escapist. You should face your problems. This was the lesson taught by science teacher. Fine. So the crux of this chapter, that his teachers, his parents, his friends, the parents of his friends, everyone around him made him a good human being, what APJ Abdul Kalam became later on. Okay, so you will be telling me now the question answers. Where was Abdul Kalam's house? I'm giving two questions to one student to save time. Okay, where was Abdul Kalam's house? What do you think Deena Mani is the name of? Give a reason for your answer. So these are the two questions. Harmeet Kaur, you have raised hand first, so you can answer these two questions better.
First, Abdul Kalam's house was on the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram.
It's Mosque, beta. Mosque nahi bolna. It's Mosque Street, Rameshwaram. Yes.
Second, it is a well-known Tamil newspaper.
What do you think Deena Mani is the name of? Harmeet?
Tamil newspaper.
Yes, then Deena Mani is the name of a Tamil newspaper. And give a reason. What is the reason? How do you get to know about it? You remember when World War II was going on, at that time, how APJ Abdul Kalam would read the news. And you can mute yourself for me. Right? So the reason behind this is, Deena Mani is the name of the Tamil newspaper. When World War II was going on, APJ Abdul Kalam would read the news about World War in that newspaper, through which we get to know that this is the name of the newspaper. So third and fourth question, who were Abdul Kalam's school friends? What did they later become? How did Abdul Kalam earn his first wages? Two questions. Those who want to answer, raise your hand, beta. Come on. Only Harmeet has raised hand. What about others? Diya, Jia, Titiksha, Deepkirti. Nobody raising hand. What happened? Or if you know the answer to one question, even then you can raise hand. Okay. Fine. I asked two because to save time. In joining and leaving, it takes time. That's why. Nobody is there. Answer to this question. Don't write in the chat box. I'm asking you to unmute. Yes, Harmeet has again raised hand. Harmeet, chance goes to you. Yes, Titiksha has raised hand. Sorry, Harmeet. In the meantime, so Titiksha would like to answer. Yes, Who were Abdul Kalam's school friends immediately, beta? Come on. I'm not able to hear you, Pratiksha. Okay, let me give you answer for this rather than wasting time. So, Ramanand Shastri, Shiv Prakash.
Ma'am, I want to answer.
Yes, definitely. Then speak. Yes, beta, you can speak.
Ramanand Shastri, Aravati, Shiva Prakashan were his school friends. Ramanand Shastri became the prize child from his
yes, beta.
Aravindan went to business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims. Shiva Prakashan became the chaplain contractor of Southern Railways. Fourth question. How did Abdul Kalam's first wages?
Can you speak louder, Nikisha?
Abdul Kalam earned his first wages by distributing newspapers.
Yes. Fine. You can mute yourself, beta. Clear? So Ramanand Shastri, Shiv Prakashan, and Aravindan were the school friends. Fine. We know about APJ Abdul Kalam. He became aeronautical scientist later on. And Ramanand joined his father in the priesthood. Fine. Of Rameshwaram temple only. And rest of the friends, one of the friends he joined is catering business. Fine. So you need to tell, you, I already made you underline when we were reading the chapter. Fine, those questions. Then we have, how did Abdul Kalam earn his first wages? He earned his first wages by distributing newspaper. Don't get confused by tamarind seeds here. Because they've asked about wages, okay? Wages, they are saying. So, had he earned any money before that? In what way? Next question is, yes, Raghav has raised hand. 9C, Raghav.
Yes, ma'am. He had earned money before also. He used to collect the tamarind seeds and sell them to a provision shop on the mosque street. A day's collection would fetch him the princely sum of a one.
You can mute yourself, Raghav. That was not audible. Jia Mago has raised hand. Yes, Jia, you can speak, but please speak louder.
Abdul Kalam, before selling newspapers, used to collect tamarind seeds and sold them in a shop on the mosque street. He could earn one anna by that.
Yes, this is the answer, correct answer. Next is, how does the author describe his father, his mother, and himself? Yes, Lisa.
Yes, ma'am. The author describes his father as a simple man. He had neither much formal education nor wealth, but he had great wisdom. He was very large-hearted. He was very considerate. He was also an Austrian man.
Yes, but on the very first page, they have given the information about parents. Fine. So you can note down from there only. Yes, Lisa, continue by telling about his mother. Lisa, you can continue by telling about his mother also.
Yes, ma'am. The author describes his mother as kind and large-hearted. She used to feed many people every day. She had all the motherly qualities. The author went to Ramanathapuram for further studies. She became emotional then.
Yes, and what does he tell about himself?
Yes, ma'am. About himself, the author says that he was one of many children. He was a short boy with rather undistinguished looks. Theirs was a middle-class Tamil family in Rameshwaram.
Very good. So all the answers given correctly by Lisa. Well done. What characteristics does he say he inherited from his parents? But these are the characteristics does. You read the question. Sometimes you can say the traits, the physical traits. Don't tell that he was a short boy with undistinguished looks and all. Here you will be telling the qualities which he inherited from his father. Okay, Tanveen is there. One girl from 9C. If you can speak louder, Tanveen.
Yes, ma'am. According to Abdul Kalam, his father was an austere man. So he inherited honesty and self-discipline from him. and from his mother he inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness.
Very good. So all the answers, students, well done. You're giving absolutely correct answers. I even need not add anything into it. So discuss these questions in class with your teacher and then write down your answers in 2 or 3 paragraphs each. Beta, now I have, you will be writing these questions in your FAIR notebook, okay? Part 1 and part 2. Rest is your homework, the exercises and all. You will be solving on the book itself. If grammar is there and all, if any confusion will be there, I will be sharing with you. Fine, tomorrow we will be doing grammar. Bell has gone, so we can't continue now. Clear? Only 1 minute is left. So you will be doing these questions which we have discussed today on your FAIR notebook. We have already done one writing skill for the week in the beginning only. Now what is left with for this week? We are left with grammar part only. So tomorrow when you will be joining, immediately you will be keeping your FAIR notebooks and pen with you. Fine, so that we can do grammar over there. Clear, beta? Have a nice day.